just be throwing, throwing my utensils away so they won't have to wash it. You know how you know what you got in your kitchen? Let me get my tasting glass. Really quick, really quick, really quick. With some ice. Okay, so this is going to be real quick, y'all. So, I made this for the, Shalina, I'm going to call you. I slept the day away as soon as I got out of work because my tooth was bothering me. And then the next day, I had my dentist appointment. So, I'm going to call, I promise. As soon as I get off this live, I'm going to call you. So, hey, you ring on. So, I made this the day of the, I'm gonna call you. I'm on quarantine. Okay, so I made this the day we had the twins, you know, a little graduation thing. So this was our adult drink. It's really easy. So we have the Lipton Peach. Because I'm going pretty far away from my to make sure I saw this. Light too bright. Okay. So it's this Lipton peach tea. Just the regular Lipton peach tea in the can. It's less than $3. Some frozen peaches. You can put however many you want because some people like to garnish with it, so that's fine. Look, I got some Parmesan peach. Now, usually I drink crayon peach. So let me show y'all. So usually I drink crayon peach. Okay. So, but when you're making a mixed drink like this, Big Batch, it's really not necessary. And this is really good. So I wasn't about to use all my crayon peach on this drink. So I use Parmesan. And I don't get no headache or anything. So it is $20 for this big old bottle. So. Yeah, this is what I use for this drink. And then we're going to need some, I'm going to put some peach schnapps in there as well. Now, remember what I told y'all when making these drinks, which of course we put Parmesan in there, so you don't really have to worry about alcohol, but this has alcohol in it too. And we need some sugar. So, the first thing we're going to do, I have three quarts of water, but initially I'm gonna pour 2 quarts of water in here first, because when we put the peaches in there and all this other stuff, we're gonna add to it. This is like a gallon, you know, a little mason jar thing. Y'all know I love my mason jar, so it's like a gallon, but I'm not gonna, it's just me drinking away. Okay, so I'm going to start with just 2 quarts. But like I say, you can definitely make this in big batches. Just adjust it because you're going to taste it as you go anyway. So I'm going to do about 2 quarts. Let's see. Just about 2 quarts. But remember, I always taste anything you do, taste it as you go. Okay, so then we have our peach Lipton tea. I used to do sangria a lot, and that is very expensive when you're doing big batches. Oh, it is? Hold on, let me try to. Let me turn. Is that better, or am I talking low? Let me put it out. Is that better? Can y'all hear me? A little better? I try to talk louder. My whole house still sleeps. So. Okay, so. I'm going to start off my stuff ready. So I'm going to start off with a cup and a half of this. And so I make this sweet, so you can't really taste the alcohol. That's why. Actually, actually. I'm going to just put one cup. And we'll go from there and we'll taste it to see how it is. Now, the fun part is the power of the Palmaslan, and you can use any peach flavor alcohol. Okay, Christian Brothers have one. Like I said, you can use crayon peach, but I mean, I don't think it's necessary spending more money than you need to. Even when I do my sangria, when I first started making it, I was like buying all this wine and spending like $200-$300 on a batch of sangria. When Trader Joe's have their red wine for $2, and nobody could tell the difference, and nobody got a headache. These meals is okay. So, I'll measure for y'all. Okay, but y'all know. I don't really be measuring like that, especially with alcohol. I think once you do that, that means it's strong. But I will measure. So let's start with one cup of the peach liquor. Okay, maybe a cup and a fourth. And I'll post it too. I'll post it so y'all can save it. So that's a cup and a half of the peach liquor, and I'm gonna do, one and one fourth cup of peach liquor, and I'm gonna do one fourth cup of peach schnapps. Okay, they went a little over, but okay. Okay, and then we're gonna get, let's do three quarter cups of sugar. So this is a half a cup, so I'll just do a half of this one. And then it's just going to stir. So that it's going to be really, really, really quick. Real quick. And so don't use cold water. Okay, so I know it's too early to be drinking, but I said, you know what? I need to get up and make this video so people can run to the store and get their frozen peaches. I know the liquor store closed, so hopefully I got some crayon peach or something. But yeah, you know. And if you don't have your peach drink, I don't know, because I ain't never. You know, that's the whole purpose of the drink, because it's peach. But let's see. That is so good. But I want more alcohol, so at this point, if you're not a drinker, you don't have to put more alcohol, but I'm going to put more alcohol. Okay? So I'm going to put another cup. I'm going to put another cup. I'll put another fourth cup of peach schnapps. And then I'm going to put another half a cup of the tea mix. And so y'all see how much liquor we got left? You know, all the people that just come to your house just to drink up the stuff, say more than welcome to drink this up because you ain't spend nothing but about 25. You could make a bunch of batches for about $25. So yeah, let me drink on. Okay, we just add a little stir. Now you can add lemon slices, but I wouldn't because you don't want to take away the peach flavor. You can also make this the night before, but the reason I don't let my peaches like marinate in there, like a sangria, is because your frozen peaches are gonna act as your ice cubes too. So you're flavoring it and you're flavoring it and you're, you know, keeping it covered because, you know, ice and water it in there. And then you just throw your peaches in there. And then you just, you know. And there we have our just peachy drink. Oh, yeah, Kelly, you had it too. Yeah, girl. People been asking me to do this video and I'm like, we need to do this video. Because I haven't really been really drinking like that. And then I have to start taking my antibiotics. Well, I was supposed to start Thursday. But I'm like, I'm drinking this weekend, so I'm going to start my antibiotics Monday. I may start them tomorrow, actually. But yeah, that is the peachy drink. And so how you could, you know, you can definitely top, you know, your drink with a peach if you want. But I'm really weird. Like, I like peach flavor, but I don't like to eat peaches. Like, I like peach cobbler, but I don't like peach. I eat the crust and the juice, so I'm like really weird. But yeah, so that is a really quick. Let me do my last little taste. So yep, that's our peach. It is Shavonda. I made this for the boys' event, and it was so good. And it was my first time like trying this. So whenever I'm like doing something on the fly, I don't make a lot of it. But I really regret I didn't buy more alcoholic peaches because we went through it. So. That is perfect. Like, you can't, it's like, I put a lot of alcohol in there. I put like two and a half cups, two and one fourth cups of Parmesan. But you can't taste it. You know liquor in there. So I'm making Brian some, he wants stove top and then put in today. Josh is up for his sleep. I told him not to stay, it's 10, it's almost 11, so Josh upstairs asleep. I told him don't stay on the game all night. He was in tour room, so I'm about to go wake him up. But yeah, I gotta make some of them pudding on the stove. And I'm not a fan. I mean, I make it, but I'm not a fan of it, but Brian likes it on the stove, so I probably won't be in there. Because it's definitely like blood. But I have to separate ours because he likes warm damn pudding. I like cold damn pudding. So I'm going to put me a little bowl. Corey, no, I'm going to put this in my baby cave because he's going to pour his own cup. Because, you know, he's sneaking my stuff. So, yeah, y'all. This is how it looks. It's really pretty. And so, like I said, you can add more peaches, less peaches. Add a bigger container. This is about how much tea we have left. So if you're doing like a big batch, which nobody should be doing a big batch for no party because corona. But yeah, this is all I use and it is really, really good. So I'll take a picture and post the ingredients that I used and everything, that way y'all could try it. But I just had to come and share. I'm about to do a banana pudding on the stove. And yeah, so I'm gonna post that video to my YouTube channel, because, you know, a lot of people like drink when I'm sour. I'm not a fan. I just don't like cooking because it's very time consuming. But I'm going to do it for my love, you know. And I'll post that, so be looking for that, because, you know, everybody talking about they want sugar daddy, and sugar daddy's from they've been able to put it like their mama used to make it, and trust me, Anna Mae was not using whipped cream, she was using almond style with some flour. So yeah, I'm about to start drinking at 10:49 a.m. and get my day started. I'm not really cooking today. Today's just Saturday for me. But yeah, y'all try this. Let me know if you like it. I'm about to take a picture and post all the ingredients so y'all could screenshot it and have it when you go to the store. But it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 ingredients. Okay? That's it. And it's cheap. Y'all know, people come to your house just to drink. So make one big batch of this and call it a day. Don't drink tea. Then do the watermelon lemonade that I did on the other line. I need to do that again so I can take a picture of that and post the ingredients for that. So I'll do that next week when I make those burrito tacos. I'll make the lemonade. Misha, girl, this is good. Really good. Misha, did you even get some when you was here? I don't think you got none. Did you get some? Oh, you don't drink tea. I can't remember. But yeah, so I'm gonna get started on his room again, so I can do my acrylic swatches. I gotta do my chores so I can play. But I hope y'all have a good day. Oh, okay, which one's this one, Shaniqua, or the watermelon lemonade? I'm gonna do a watermelon lemonade. I'll do that. Do I have any more watermelon left? Hold on, let me see. Yeah, I'll have to. Hold on, I lost my hair. Shit. I'll go because I'm out of watermelon syrup. So I'll go to the store Monday and I'll do it for you before the end of the week, because I know you gotta get the ingredients and stuff. So I'll do a batch of that and show you how to do that and take a picture so you have it to go to the store. So yeah, and with that, you can use any kind of watermelon alcohol, but I used Ciroc, and I know I'm probably saying it wrong. I used Ciroc last time. I like it so much better, because last time I used, disclaimer, anybody 21 and below, you can't drink, okay? I'm supposed to say it right here. I used Smirnoff watermelon. It was not good to me. So, the Smirnoff, I wouldn't recommend, but the Ciroc, let me show you. The Ciroc Summer Watermelon was really good. Like, I downed this. And I don't usually drink Ciroc, so, but this was something Brian already had over there, so I tried it. So yeah, if y'all could find this, the Ciroc Summer Watermelon, get this. If not, try another watermelon flavor. Plus, we enhance the watermelon flavor with this. But I think what I'm gonna do next time is I'm gonna put a watermelon in a blender and strain it in there to really enhance that natural watermelon flavor. But we'll do that next week. I'll do it. I'll shoot for Wednesday. It'll give you 2 days to get it. But yeah, I'm about to make this banana pudding. And What else I gotta cook today? I don't know. We quarantined. And I mean, see, ain't the one I finally did it. And I mean, quarantine. I'm gonna take a picture and put the ingredients, so it's easier than going through this, going back watching live. So I'm about to get my day started. I just had to put some eyebrows on to come here and show y'all how to make this drink. Hopefully I'll have some peach alcohol. If you don't, and you really wanna make this, I could possibly set some on the porch for you, because quarantine, you know? But yeah, because I know liquor stores are closed today. So I really should leave this Thursday, so I apologize. But I didn't want mine sitting for 2 days. Because you don't want the peaches to become like too mushy. So I will talk to y'all later. Enjoy y'all day. And I will post, I will post the banana pudding video. Y'all know what? I was supposed to be recording this on my camera. That's exactly what happened with that spaghetti recipe. I had my camera sitting right here because I'm like, okay, while I'm talking to y'all, I could be recording this video for my YouTube channel. And I ain't even here recording. Now I'm gonna have to make this again. Not today, but eventually. Anyway, because I can't get it to save on Facebook for some reason. I'm supposed to be able to download it, but it doesn't. But anywho, this is the drink, and I will talk to y'all later. I'm going to put this in my bag today before Josh gets the sipping, because he's known for stealing my drink. So, y'all enjoy the rest of y'all's day, and I will talk to y'all later.